Hey guys, thanks for joining me. Today, I'm going to show you how to connect your mouse and keyboard to Xbox Series X or S. If you want setup instructions for PS5, click in the link at the top right or in the description down below. Let's get to it. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the RX250-K and RX250-M and a Series S, but the process should be exactly the same for your preferred mouse or keyboard or an Xbox Series X. You'll be happy to know that the setup is so easy. There's three USB ports on the Xbox, two on the back and one on the front, so you can plug your keyboard in the back and the mouse in the front. If your devices have RGB, they should light up, meaning that they're getting power. You won't see any message on screen to show that they're connected, and the mouse won't work on the home screen, but you'll be able to use the arrow keys on your keyboard to move around. You press the Enter button to select and Escape to go back. In the device settings, under Devices and Connections, you can find settings for the mouse. There's the pointer speed, which changes how fast the mouse moves, and also if your mouse has a physical DPI switch, you can still press it to cycle through the DPI options on your mouse. There's the switch primary and secondary mouse button, which sets it as a left or right-handed mouse. Once you have those settings dialed in how you like, we can get into a game. As a side note, even though the Xbox has native keyboard and mouse support, it's still up to the game developer's discretion if they allow it or not in their game. So it's not going to be all games, including some first-party games that'll have keyboard and mouse support. I'll leave a link to our list of Xbox keyboard and mouse compatible games down in the description, next to that subscribe button. So, let's jump into a game of Halo Infinite and see how it plays. At first use, it feels more accurate than the controller. Normally I'd have to ADS to make some of these longer range shots. And like I said, you still have the option to use the DPI switch on your mouse to make it more or less responsive. For this one, I have it either set to 1600 or 2400 DPI, depending on the game. And if you're jumping from PC, it may take some getting used to, but eventually you'll adjust. So that's how you set up your mouse and keyboard on Xbox. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments section below. And if you found this video helpful, why not leave a like or share it with someone who needs it? Thanks for watching.